quick explanation of PWM and how it's used on motors like DC motors. So PWM is pulse width modulation, and it kind of describes a waveform used to control motors. So imagine we have a zero line, excuse the squeaking, and so we'll call that zero, and whatever our voltage is. So I'll talk about it in relation to a spindle motor on a CNC machine. So okay, that's say, I don't know, 60 volts for some of them, might be more. And I'll just do a, if I leave that in blue, I can do the waveform in red. So one way you could have vary the speed of a motor is to change the voltage of it. But since actually a lot of electronics is digital electronics is a little bit easier, instead the digital way to do it is to cut how long you've got the electricity turned onto the motor for. I'll kind of show you what I mean. So if I say actually we've got these voltage levels on a y-axis, and on the x-axis we have time, and say we had at some point what we call a duty cycle of 50%, so 50% on, 50% off. So imagine that this was your period of the wave. So this might be, I don't know, let's say 50 hertz, and that depends on the specification of your motor and your controller. So you say, well, okay, so about there, so 50% of the time it's on and 50% of the time it's off. So there's a block of 50%. And then if we wanted to say, okay, you know what, we're going to reduce speed to 25%, then we'd have, call that 25% on and 75% off, okay, for this block here. And then we also say, well, okay, we'll go, I'm going to have 75% because it's easy for me to draw, and it's pretty much more of the same. There's your 75%. And so by varying where that line in the middle of that period crosses from voltage to zero, you vary how much voltage your device, your motor, is getting, and therefore what speed it's turning. These devices, there may be an upper limit before they go wrong, so one thing you might not want is to end up with 100%, which is where you've just got it on, because that may destroy devices, blow fuses, blow things up. And that was one of the things that went wrong with my CNC machine, is it was outputting 100%, which is actually more current than the device could handle, because as the voltage goes up, the thing spins, the current and the power going through is higher, and it blew something up. So PWM, in a nutshell, for DC motors. It is slightly different, it's still PWM, it's still related for things like servo motors, and I'll go into that another time. Anyway, go make stuff and be awesome. Bye.